daily uses means clothes. This is our last topic where we are going to discuss about some plant fibers. So first we are going to discuss cotton. What actually cotton means? Cotton that generally we use in our home, like rui, got it? So this cotton are grown in field, usually at place having a warm climate and black soil. Black soil is mandatory thing for growth of good cotton. Rest, cotton producing Indian states are Punjab, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, etc. Cotton plants bear fruit the size of a lemon called cotton balls, which burst open upon maturing and the seed wrapped up in a cotton fiber become visible. Cotton is generally picked by hands, like these cotton balls we just pluck out through our hands. How we get fiber, or you can say proper clothes from the cotton. So here are few steps. First is ginning. Ginning means it is a process of separating cotton fiber from cotton seeds. We are just separating using these needles. We are separating cotton fiber and cotton seeds. So in the above picture, it is shown that we are using one machine, whereas on the lower picture, a man is using needle, means he is doing it manually. Got it? So nowadays, double roller cotton ginning machine are widely in use. This is the basic, you can say, and this is a basic process in which we differentiate, or which we separate cotton seeds and cotton fibers. Next is carding. Carding is another process which happen after ginning. In this, ginned cotton fiber is present in lumps. Of course, it's not lumps, it's lumps, means gucche gucche mein wo present hota hai, and are stretched with hands on a cushion of line needles, so that we get fluffy, it become fluffy. Here you can see one machine is there. This is carding machine. Next is spinning, means spinning fiber into yarn. Previously we get fiber and then we are converting it into yarn. For yarn we use hand spindle, spinning wheels and machines. Here we have a spinning machine, and you have heard about charkha, that is spinning wheel. Got it? Firstly used by Mahatma Gandhi, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. Next is weaving. What we do after spinning, we weave that. Means we just convert yarn into you can say a proper fabric. First we convert fiber into yarn and yarn into fabric on looms, hand looms and power looms. Power looms means machine, hand looms means those machines or those things we use through our hand. It is a process of weaving threads and arrange it into lengthwise, calling them wraps, and crosswise calling it weft. Means the straight strands are called wrap, and crosswise means crisscross strand is known as weft. Weft is at, of course, right angle of the wrap. In this process of weaving, half the wraps are raised and another half are lowered alternatively, and weft is passed through the body wrap from right to left and from left to right. Here you can see a man. This man is actually weaving. Got it? Here you can see weft is there at a 90 degree angle, and here you can see a wrap is there, means strand like structure, and here weft is there, means crisscross like fiber. These single fiber get crisscrossed to form weft. Next is knitting. Knitting is a process in which fabric is made by interlocking loops of a single yarn with the help of knitting needles by machines, or means basically knitting means all the clothes we are using this time, we are wearing this time, is knitted. So in cotton we use cotton yarn, in summers we use cotton yarn, and whereas in winters we use wool. Next is stitching. When we get this fabric, then means proper cloth, then what we do, we make designer dresses, like different dress for you can say different dress for party, different for school, etc. You know, previously in early days people just wrap their body with a unstitched fabric, but nowadays we are just making it so super fantastic dresses. Where we use cotton? We use cotton in making curtains, carpets and towels. Next, it is a good absorber of water, so we use it in surgical cotton and surgical bandage, and as a whip in cloth or dusted. Saaf safai ke liye bhi hum isko use karte hain. Raw cotton is made to make wick. Wick means jo diya ki batti hoti hai beta, jisse aap puja uja karte hain, uske liye bhi ye use hota hai. And also for stuffing pillows and quilts. Rajai aur pillows mein jo rui bhari jati hai, wo kya hoti hai? Raw cotton hoti hai. Rough cotton clothes is used as mop. Matlab jo poncha hota hai, jo farsh saaf karne ke liye hota hai, uske liye rough cotton clothes use kiye jate hain. Waste cotton is good for making fine quality paper also, because they have cellulose. And next we use cotton for rayon, which is a partially synthetic fiber. Cotton is also used for stitching garments. Next is khadi. Beta, khadi was firstly started by Mahatma Gandhi, and why he started using handmade cotton fabric, just so as to boycott foreign material. This signifies unity, and also that we are not dependent on others, and we just want to get rid of or get freedom from all those foreign materials. Next is jute. Jute, another natural fiber from a plant. Jute is valuable fiber obtained from the bark of the stem of the plant. Jute is widely cultivated in West Bengal, in India and in Bangladesh. It is also cultivated in Bihar, Assam and Tripura. Jute plants grow well in places where there is plenty of rain. And plant mixture is, you know, this plant mainly grow in flooded soil, where we just you can say irrigate lots and lots of water. Jute mainly sown in March and is ready for harvesting in September. Here you can say this is raw jute and this is matured jute. Got it? Okay. How we obtain jute fiber? First, retting of plant. We just soak that jute fiber, that jute plant, for 10 to 15 days. Next is that what happened after retting. That retting means soaking of these plants softens the stem tissue, and we can extract the fiber from it. Next is stripping. Stripping means the stalks are stripped by hand, means bring out from the bark. We just bring out fiber from the bark. Next is washing and dyeing. We just wash those strips and fiber and use it, clean it, dry it, and later on use for many other purposes. So those purposes are what? First, for making strings, for sutli, in Hindi we can say, for making cords, for carpets, for rugs, for handbags, bags, and for gunny bags, means bori. Hemp. Hemp is another type. Actually, aapne dekha hoga bhang. Hum bhang se bhi hum fiber extract kar sakte hain. But it is tougher and little bigger than jute. It has the best quality, means jo gunny bags aate hain jisme hum crystal sugar and flour store karte hain, usme you can say sabse zyada acha material jo uski bori ka banta hai, wo banta hai from hemp. It is used for making stronger ropes, used for holding tents and drawing water from the wells. It is also used in production of handbags, carpets, nets and paper. Leaves from hemp plant also yield drugs. आपने बहुत सुना होगा marijuana और भांग. ये आपने देखा भी होगा. Look at this picture. this is leaf of bhang and this is plant of bhang or hemp. Next is linen or flax. Linen actually comes from flax plant or flax seeds. In Hindi we can say tisi. So fiber from flax called linen comes from the stem. As at one time linen was quite a popular fabric being used for drapery and even in lungi. Seeds from flax yield the linseed oil used in paints, polish and as a medicine. Here we have coir. So this coir means the extract from, or you can say outer covering of a coconut. We also use it as fiber in making mattress, foot mats, carpets, ropes and rugs. Mainly it is found in coastal areas like Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, etc. Next is silk cotton. You know, you will feel amazing after watching the actual picture of this kapok. You know, when I was a kid, that time I used to play with its pollens. Like Raja Rani hai, chalo khelte hai. Bahut sare seeds, bahut sare flowers lage hue the iske. Tab mujhe nahi pata tha ki isko hum aise use karte hai for, you can say for drawing fiber. But this is known as silk cotton fiber from kapok, the silk cotton tree. Locally, it is known as simul tree with spiny vertical growth trunks and horizontal branches wearing bright red flowers. Pods of kapok tree are large, filled with minute seeds, covered with over flowering white silky fiber. Hence the name silk cotton means it is quite lustrous and soft, so that's why it is known as silk cotton. Fiber is too smooth to be woven into fabric. It is used as a filler in cushions and pillows. Kapok is primarily grown for its wood, used for making butts for guns and matchsticks, but nowadays we are using pine. So students, if you like this video, do like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to hit that